Doug Gilmore will be the main focal point. Right along the boards, the initial hit was on Keane, and then Hatcher came in from behind, and I think it was the hit being on the numbers on the back of Kelger that caught the eye of McCreary, the referee.
Dave Reed locked up with Chance behind the goal. Nasruddin picking it up for the Hawks, tossing it off the glass, not out. Chambers holding it in, down low, shot, Hackett makes the save. Verbeek was scurrying out front, and now he and Chance get the gloves up. Morrow is there as well. Daze ahead to center ice. He works it in past Matvichuk. Hatcher measures him, hits him hard in the corner off the Belfer's left. Matvichuk crushes Gilmore. And the Stars are able to play it out. Daze on his own at the Dallas line. Sidor battling strongly with him. Gilmore picks it off. Centers a drive. They score! Lettinen on his way after the puck. Behind the goal quickly to Hull in the far corner. From Adano out front. He was sealed off, and the puck comes to Amati. He'll clear it off Zhamnov at center ice. Hatcher waiting there and got him up high, but knocked him on his fanny. Here come the Stars counterattacking. Madonna kicking it across the line, but right to Royer. And he'll play it out. Arian Hatcher. Very physical first period for the Dallas captain.
Very.
They wave the icing, and here come the Stars. Zubov up ahead. Morrow went in and threw a hit. The Hawks were assessed 6 5-minute majors for fighting in their opening night win, and now they want something in front of the Dallas bench. Bob Probert is just hanging around. He had strapped himself to the front gate of the Dallas bench, and he is ready to take on any and all comers, and they've got some other youngsters, Razor, who also wouldn't mind mixing it up.
Well, Daryl Sidor seems to fight nothing but heavyweights. He came flying in. Initially it was Probert and Jamie Wright right in front of the Stars bench. Probert was coming over as a reaction to Hatcher's hit on Zhamnov and wanted a piece of the Stars captain. And Smolik's out there who will do the same thing. So they all pick up their gloves, their mittens that they've lost, and cooler heads will prevail. We'll step aside, 3:50 to go first period. Hawks have a 1-0 lead over the Dallas Stars on the Stars Hockey Network. Well, Pat Verbeek is working hard to be called the most hated man, at least in the Western Conference, if not the entire NHL. And he went to the front of the Chicago net with a purpose. One was either to score a goal or draw a penalty, and he did the latter. Laflamme knocked it down the first time, and then after the shot went off of Hackett and off to the side, the young Chicago defenseman knocked him down again, and that's the one that gets him the gate.
Jeff Chance dueling. Stars win it. Sidor taking it down the boards. The Langenbrunner centering for Verbeek. He scores! Corner. Keane went after it. Now Wright chasing. Hammered Royer off the puck. Probert there. Battling with Wright. Keane hitting Probert. Royer putting Keane to the ice. Stars pick up the puck. Carboneau centering to Wright. One-timer tipped in front by Keane. Right to Jeff Hackett. And now Probert taking Carboneau behind the net. Wright coming in to help Carboneau. And a pile up of bodies right behind Jeff Hackett in the Chicago goal.
That was a good, hard-working shift by Carboneau's line. Jamie Wright and Mike Keane, they're up against some pretty big boys on the other side. Young Royer, number 6, their young rookie defenseman, is a big lad. Probert is large. Big hit on the end boards by Keane started it all, and then he got a face full of Royer. Carboneau came in after. Just good, solid, hard work forechecking by that trio up front for Dallas, and they got a kind of a dribbler chance on Hackett.
The seconds remaining on the power play. Marshall tossing it behind the goal. Probert is on. Back at full strength. Stars attack. It's loose. They score! Jamie Langenbrunner. Verbeek was standing in the crease. The puck was there first, I believe. He was creating more havoc down there, and the Stars are up 3-1.
Just changed his last name to Sandpaper. He's abrasive. Hackett wants an appeal from upstairs, but even if they did go upstairs, and I'm not so sure that Verbeek wasn't in the crease, but I think he got shoved in. At least he got clipped in there. He was in the crease, there's no question. Now, the different ruling this year is that the goal judge upstairs, either Ed Baker or Robert Firth, can call down to the referee and say there was a man in the crease. And then the question is, was he pushed in? See what the call is.
No goal. I don't know. Bill McCreary was shaking his head.
No goal.
No goal. He He's explaining now to the captains, Darian Hatcher and Chris Chelios. Verbeek was in the crease after the puck got there, but then the puck left and Verbeek did not.
Well, this what happened on this one, too, is exactly why there is a blue area painted down there to protect goalies. Because if you have players that just stumble and bumble their way in and knock goaltenders down when their focus is on the puck, that's how guys get hurt. Now, he didn't really collide with Hackett, but he was in there. And although he got clipped with a high stick on his way in, he didn't get pushed in. And he took a pretty good high stick from LaFlamme, the defenseman of Chicago. Verbeek wears a visor, and it knocked his little windshield up on his forehead. Over there in Japan, but I think they have a new favorite hero, Theo Fleury. He was Mr. Popular over there. They started the season in Japan with two games against the Sharks. And everywhere he went, I guess he was just a hero. Everyone wanted pictures with Theo.
Well, diminutive compared to the
it's probably a giant over there.
Uh-oh. Here's Chambers handing it off to Marshall. Off Severin skates. It comes to center ice. He's got Probert at center ice. Here we go. Brett Severin and Bob Probert. Severin tried an uppercut and missed. Probert holding him off. Probert threw a short right up the side of the helmet. Now he throws a couple of rights, landing them on the side of Severin's head. Along the near boards, Probert tosses the right glove. Severin came back with a right. They're hanging on to each other. Two very big men indeed. Probert getting in tight. Oh, and Severin came in with a short right as well. Left hook by Severin. Didn't hit him. Short punches. Oh, Severin got a couple loose. Tagged him a couple of times. Probert back. Oh, they're lathering each other. Probert with the right. Severin with the left. They both go down in a heap in front of the penalty box. That was a good one.
Severin went southie on him at the end after a lengthy wrestling match, which really tires you out. Severin a little jacked up in the penalty box afterward. Probert's had a scowl on him the whole game here tonight, and he went after. It looked like the two of them hooked up near center ice, looked at one another and said, well, let's add 5 penalty minutes to our totals on the season. So they dropped the mitts, and they did it like men. Good tilt. Yeah, just innocent looking. They hook up. Severin bumped him. Probert turned to him and said, would you like to engage me? Severin said, yes, I think I will. They dropped the extra equipment they were carrying and went at it. Severin laid a pretty good beating on Rob Ray here on Saturday night and held his own and got some good shots in there against one of the toughest customers this game has seen. On the ice, but he's drawn a crowd every time.
LaFlamme hit by Keane. Ludwig is on. Power play is over for the Hawks. Ludwig coming in, and he just freight trained LaFlamme,
who goes about close to 220, just through the shoulder right into the sternum of LaFlamme after he got out of the penalty box.
It goes deep into the Dallas zone. Hatcher has it there. Gilmore can't settle it. Center it. Matvichuk blocked the pass. Kilgore along the boards to Gilmore. Shot. Blocked. Matvichuk all the way down. He scores!
Oh-ho!
Right before the horn sounded. I believe that one will count with about 3/10 of a second left on the clock. It doesn't matter. The Stars win the game 2-3-1.
Well, the red light came on, and the rule is that if the red light came on, then obviously the green light, because if the green light comes on to signify the end of the period, the red light can't go on. The Hawks don't care. They're going home. They've lost this one, whether it's 2-1 or 3-1.
Stars win this one 3-1. We'll come back and have a wrap on the Dallas Stars Hockey Network.